Yo,
what's up?
This is Patrick.
And I'm Brad.
And in this video, we're going to talk about the difference between dedicated and serverless SQL pools. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam this guy. All right, Brad, thank you so much for joining us on Guy in the Cube. Before we get started, why don't you do a quick introduction to tell the people who you are?
So I'm Brad Schacht. I'm a principal program manager on the Azure Synapse Analytics team. In my portion of the team, we are really focused on working with customers on a day-to-day basis and helping make sure that they are successful and bringing that feedback back into the product.
In short, Brad knows a lot about Synapse. That's all I'm going to say. All right, so Brad, you know, I'm an old SQL Server guy. I started tinkering with Synapse when it first came out. Then I went away and I started doing Power BI and didn't touch it. And probably about a year ago, I started getting back into it and I discovered this thing called serverless. And I'm like, this is nice, especially for Power BI, because I'm going to cache up data. I'm not running queries very often. It just kind of worked out. And then someone would say, Patrick, you should really take a look at this dedicated. I'm like, why would I need dedicated? And so I reached out to you and I'm like, Brad, what's the difference? And then maybe I can make a better decision.
There's a lot of value in that serverless pool. It's really great for doing data exploration, doing that logical data warehouse over top of the data lake so you don't have to do a ton of data modeling. Really helps you get up and running with your data warehouse or your Power BI reporting in general. But sometimes you do need a little bit of extra horsepower. You need that really strict data model. You need those predictable SLAs. And so sometimes you do need to look at that dedicated system.
So you're telling me that I can use serverless though, if it fits the use case, right?
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah. Tons of my customers use it out there without even using the dedicated SQL pools at all. Nothing wrong with that.
All right. So enough of all this talking. You guys know how we like to do a Guy in the Cube. We're not heading to my laptop. Let's head to Brad's laptop.
So here we are inside of my Synapse Analytics workspace. And the really cool thing about serverless, all I have to know is that I'm sitting here inside my data lake right now, looking at a set of flat files. In this case, I've got my on-time performance data for my airlines. And all I have to do to query data, right-click on it and say, select top 100 rows. And just like that, I can click a button and I can run a query. So I don't even have to know how to write T-SQL. I don't have to know all this other syntax. All I have to know is where my data is and I can right-click and run a query on top of it.
And I think this is great. This is so easy. If I write a process just to dump files into a folder, it could be a data lake, it could be all these other different places, I can just connect my Synapse to that storage account and then start querying it using serverless. And I don't need to do anything. I don't need to create tables. I don't need to move data into tables. I don't need to persist data anywhere. It just lives where it lives. And I query it when I need it. I can modify those queries. If I only want four columns from, let's say, the Parquet file, I can get those four columns. If I want eight columns, I just go modify the query and pull in what I need. It just seems like the perfect place to do everything I want.
Yeah, it really does reduce that time to insight dramatically. And in fact, there's a lot more that you can even do with it with just a couple of little wildcards inside the URL there that I can show you if you want to take a look
at it. Yeah, let's take a look.
Here's that same query that we ran just a moment ago. You'll notice that on my query, I've got this data separated out by year, by month, and then I've got a set of files at the lowest level. But Patrick, I know we don't just want to look at October of 1987 when we're trying to figure out our, you know, which flight we should be taking. But what we can do really easily is we can come over here, we can toss a couple of wildcards by just putting a star inside this file path. And what you'll notice now is I can actually use those wildcards in my query and say, you know what, let me look at all the data from 2019.
So just by introducing those wildcards, it'll traverse all the subfolders within that location in the storage account or in my data lake.
Whether it's one file or 10,000 files. All you have to do is put that wildcard. It'll pick everything up, piece it all together, and then allow you to query the data just as you normally would.
Nice. That's nice. I like it. And I don't have to worry about taking that data from those flat files, Parquet, CSV, whatever it is, and then moving it over to actual schemas. Now I'm locked into this schema. I have flexibility with serverless.
Yeah, absolutely. And you can do, as you mentioned, all those sort of analytical queries that you would normally want to do. If I wanted to come over here and take a look at all of my flights that came between a couple of cities for a particular airline on a set of dates. But if I wanted to start joining tables together inside of here, you've probably noticed this. It's not the most friendly syntax once you start having to come in here and like nest all these open row set things together.
Yeah, I think you're like some type of psychic or something, Brad. You're reading my mind because I'm looking at those queries and I've been writing SQL statements, and this is not scary to me, but for someone that's using Power BI, for example, or someone using Excel, this could be really, really scary for them. And they may go, you know what? I don't want to have anything to do with this. There's got to be a better way for them to access these serverless SQL.
Absolutely. And I can show you a great way to do that. If that open row set stuff is a little bit daunting for you, or maybe you just want to simplify things and do a logical data warehouse over top of your data lake, building views inside of serverless is a great way to do that. Specify the columns that I want inside my data set. I don't have to pull everything in from the files. I can do all my wildcards, so I make sure that I pick up every piece of data all the way from 1987. And then I can wrap this into a view. And now all I have to do is query the view as though it's a table inside of my SQL server. So now if you want to, you don't even have to stay here inside the web browser. You can head over to your favorite query tool like Azure Data Studio. We can now query these tables and they show up just as a list of views inside of my database.
Wow. So this makes it simple. You know, anyone consuming this, they could care less of what's on the back end. All they want to do is have easy access to the data. So if I create an object for them and then they can just go against that object, this makes it easy. This is easy to consume. If they need to modify, they can send your request to the view, add more columns. So flexible, so easy. Now, I know that with serverless, it's a separation between compute and storage. And I've noticed when I start making some really complicated queries, trying to do some analytics against this, things kind of slow down. You know how people that's consuming the C-levels, they don't want stuff slow. It needs to be as fast as possible. Is this where dedicated really shines?
Absolutely. Where serverless is going to be that data lake, querying over top of the data lake type of experience, the dedicated SQL pool is going to be a lot more of that traditional SQL route. So we actually run SQL Server underneath the covers of everything. It's going to be that more familiar create table type syntax. You're going to import the data into your dedicated pool. So there's a bit more work that goes into getting up and running. But like you said, it comes with the added benefit of ridiculous performance. Where we're spending time doing, you know, 50, 60 seconds to do a query over there on the serverless side, yeah, it's easy to get up and running. But if you need that predictable, fast performance, set data types, everything really structured, then you're definitely going to want to go over to the dedicated SQL pool.
I know you're going to show us an example.
Of course I am. So if we take this query right here, this one is actually running on the serverless SQL pool. And as you can see down here in the bottom corner, the query took about 51 seconds to execute. Not too bad. Like I said, no data modeling, anything like that. But what I did was I loaded the exact same data set up into a dedicated SQL pool. And you can see at the bottom there, this one only took 6 seconds to run.
Wow.
So we're joining tables. We're doing aggregations inside the queries here. You can see just the power difference between the dedicated and the serverless SQL.
Now, it's like a SQL server, you know, so it's on, you're paying for it, but there's something interesting about this. I can actually pause this thing.
You can. Yeah. So where serverless is that paper query model, the dedicated pool, you're paying for it every second that it's up and running. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times I want to just refresh my Power BI report a couple of times a day. So my serverless, it doesn't matter if it takes 50 seconds to load my data model or if it takes 10 seconds, but I can go in and I can model the data inside of my dedicated pool. If I've got other queries that need to run throughout the day, I can let those run. And even if I only need to load it a couple of times a day, but I need that fast performance for some process, I can go in and I can pause this anytime I want to. You can even run a pipeline inside of your Synapse workspace or ADF to be able to pause that on a schedule.
Now, I would be remiss without showing a little Power BI here in this video, because I am just a sucker for it. I live it, I breathe it. And you showed me something early and it was really impressive. And I think we should wrap up to really show the true power of dedicated by showing this demo that you put together. Is that okay?
Absolutely.
All right.
So here we are inside Power BI. I'm not you, Patrick. I don't have a beautiful report here, but what I do have is some data. You can see that this report is running off my serverless SQL pool in the background, mm-hmm. and it's using those views that we were looking at just a minute ago. But the problem is every time I make a change, you can see in the performance analyzer that it takes about 30 seconds to refresh all this data on the page.
So, Brett, this is direct query mode, right? You're in direct query.
Right. And so if you wanted to, of course, you could import the data. But in this case, let's assume that we need a direct query report. Just by coming up here, changing my data source, I'll switch this over from my serverless endpoint to my dedicated SQL pool. Again, same view, same schema, same data, apply my changes. So now that I've changed the connection and everything, let's see how fast this is. 3 seconds to load the entire report.
So there is a true difference between serverless and dedicated, and you need to pick and choose. You need to do a little research and look at your use cases, what are your SLAs and things like that, before you make a hard decision on which one that you're going to use. And even if you decide to start using serverless at first, you can use pipelines and things to persist that data to your dedicated SQL pool. All right, so what do you guys think? You got any questions? You got any comments? Are you using serverless, dedicated? Brad and I would love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. It's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel. Hit that subscribe button, like our video. Big thumbs up. As always, from Adam,
Brad,
and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.